Hello everyone and welcome to another video. I'm Ruslan Alov from the International Sales Department of Circutor. Today I'd like to explain to you all in a clear and easy way what the reactive power is. Many of you might already know that the existence of reactive power in the installation can lead to a cost overrun on the electric bill. But do you know where it comes from? Please let me give you the following example. Let's say we are at the gym running on a treadmill and we gotta cover a 5 kilometers distance. Well, the combination between the distance and the slope will be the consumed energy. Therefore, the steeper the slope on the treadmill, the more energy will be required to cover those 5 kilometers. From this example, we see that something similar happens with the electrical power. But first, allow me to introduce you very quickly the main differences between resistive and inductive loads so you can understand it a bit better. On one hand, we got the resistive loads, or active power, where the current consumption goes in phase with the voltage and provides useful work or energy in form of heat, motion, etc. On the other hand, we got the reactive loads, commonly known as reactive power, which consume lagging current when the load group is inductive, or a leading current when the load group is capacitive, with regard to the voltage. In this case, it no longer generates a useful work. Instead, it's taking power and returning it back to the grid. And this is the power used to create magnetic fields or electric arcs, especially in engines, power transformers, fluorescent bulbs, and so on. That being said, the sum of active and reactive powers, their vectorial sum, of course, since they are of different natures, will be the apparent power, the total power that our installation is demanding. The existence of reactive power may cause, on one side, overconsumption that may directly affect the power transformer, saturating it and leaving the system without power. An additional current consumption that could lead not only to protective trips and cable overheating, but also to voltage drops within the installation. And finally, the most well-known effect is that the higher the reactive power consumption, the lower the cosine of phi will be, which will obviously lead us to the cost overrun due to inductive or capacitive reactive powers. In one of our upcoming videos, I'll explain you what the possible solutions are to get rid of or reduce the reactive power in the installation. Please do not hesitate to subscribe to our channel to stay tuned and leave your comments down below or reach out to us at reactive@circutor.com. We'll be more than glad to help you out. As always, thank you for your time and have a great day. And remember, the future is efficiency.